advanced hide options. When you have any report, now you can hide. You were able to hide the report based on the failed statistics by red, yellow, green, and white. But now you might want to eliminate charts where there is no variation or very less standard deviation, because that's not a measurement direction. That's an alternative direction. That's not the direction of measurement. Typically, you don't see any variation on those. You could hide those charts based on Six Sigma or by range. Sometimes if the range is very, very small, then hide those charts. So it kind of go through the entire report and hide all the charts where the range is less than 0.1. Similarly, a vector value. If it's not a prominent measurement direction, if the measurement is happening in the X, the Y, and Z, or the vector value is zero, you might want to hide those all for every point. By checking this one box, you can hide the vector value, which is less than 0.5. So sometimes there are non-design features, which are where you did not assign, where the engineering team does not assign a USL and LSL. They come in because the CMM gives you the data. You don't want to clutter your report with those points which doesn't have, or where the USL and LSL is zero, or USL and LSL is the same. Then you could actually exactly the same, not plus or minus, if they are one and one, or zero and zero. In those cases, I can do a batch hide by using these options to eliminate all my charts in my entire report that doesn't belong, creating a report only for the features that are varying, or the features that are on the prominent directions, or the design features, if you will. So I'm not going to go into this topic, but it's kind of easy to follow. It's under the hide option.